Hello, welcome to Literary Life. So first order of business for my regular viewers is, how is the audio on this? Because I know I've had several comments of late and I played with some tweaks on my fancy microphone. Tech is so not my thing. So definitely leave me feedback below if you feel like the quality is louder and coming through clearly for you all. But thank you for watching. As always, in this video, I'm going to be reviewing three thriller books that were essentially, I'm leveraging the title of one because it really captured the spirit of this literary journey, and that is On the Madness of Crowds. So all of these books are going to have groups of people, and through that group relationship, we're going to essentially see things go awry. Now, the way my book reviews work, for those of you that are not familiar or if you just need a refresh, I give every book 1 to 5 stars. 1 star, those books I did not like, probably didn't even finish reading. 2 stars, the book was okay. 3 stars, it was a good book, I liked it. 4 stars, great book, I loved the book. And then 5 stars are just those books that completely blow my mind and I want everyone to read them. All right. This was a bad journey, guys. I'm gonna tell you that right out the gate. Thankfully, there was one redeeming book in it, but let's talk about the ones. I always start with the lowest. I literally 1-starred 2 of these books. I don't even know what to say about this first book. I wanted to like this book, Bunny. So essentially, this book's set place in like a prestigious, I think it's a college university. And we have one student there who is a scholarship student. So she doesn't quite fit in. She doesn't come from the wealthy background that the majority of the students do. I think this is even a graduate program group that she's a part of. And there is, within her graduate program, a group of females that refer to themselves as bunnies. And they refer to each other as bunny. And they all have this very bizarre way of interacting and talking. They're very touchy-feely with each other. And they're like, hey, bunny. And, oh, you're so funny, bunny. And it's the weirdest thing. And I was okay with that. I'm like, okay, there's just this. I thought this is part of the gist of the book. Well, essentially what's going to happen is Samantha, their main character, who comes from a very less affluent background, is going to get invited to become a part of this friendship group, the bunnies. And it's sort of bizarre because this is a group that she really looked down on, and she had a friend that her and this friend would talk about the bunnies and essentially make fun of them because they were worth making fun of. They acted really bizarrely. And all of a sudden, she's ditching her friend to participate in the social moments with the bunnies. And I did find that to be kind of odd. You could almost understand it, though, because Samantha, the main character, is essentially isolated in her social group as part of this grad program. Like, it's her and the bunnies. So I could kind of buy into, okay, she wanted to like bridge that gap so she didn't feel so alone. But as she starts to hang out with the bunnies, things will just continue to get weirder. Now, this is a spoiler-free review, but I'm going to tell you guys, this went beyond like Monty Python weird. This went into Monty Python on acid meets Alice in Wonderland weird. Like, that is the best way I could describe it to you. Some people are going to love this book. It is that weird that I believe with my whole heart and bookish soul that there is a small population out there that is, this book is right up your alley. You have been looking for something like this. It is so bizarre and unique. It just wasn't for me. I just got to the point where I found everything so completely odd and ridiculous. I had to call it a wrap. So Bunny was definitely not my cup of tea. I don't think it's going to be for the majority of people. But like I said, I do think there is a subset. So if you tend to gravitate toward that really bizarre type of experience and are looking for a book, I would say check that one out. It may be exactly what you're looking for. Okay, now this next book that was also a 1-star for me, completely different reason and completely different group that I would recommend this book to. Okay, The Hunting Wives. So this book, essentially, we have our main character who it was a professional woman. I think she was in Chicago, if I remember correctly. And her family move down to Texas. And while there, similar situation where there is a group of women that refer to themselves as the Hunting Wives, and they essentially invite our main character into their social group in their world. And they have these like activities, their get-togethers and things they do. I totally misunderstood what this book was about. First of all, I thought when it said the Hunting Wives, I thought it was wives of hunters. Not the case. They go hunting is how they refer to their nights out for romantic escapades. And they do have rules and boundaries around it. They are married. And these rules and boundaries definitely would not apply to all of us, like me, for example. But they have set that. And then essentially what's going to happen as these women are going about their hunting Friday night party, socializing fest, there is going to be a death. A teenage, I think, girl is going to be killed, and somehow it's all going to get tied into this. And I don't know, because I stopped reading it. I found this book to be so annoying and so ridiculous. I hated the characters, and that's not a showstopper for me. I have read and loved plenty of books where I found the characters despicable. I just didn't find any depth to any of these characters. But when I was reading it, I totally thought the group of people that I think would love this book are like the Desperate Housewives fans. That was a show I could never get into. I have so many friends that watched it, loved it. My mother-in-law loved it. I tried to watch it with her several times. It just never grabbed my attention. I think if you were a fan of The Desperate Housewives or a similar type of show, and you're interested in a thriller, you may actually really, really enjoy this book. So I can see it being enticing and fun for people that like that kind of entertainment. So I would recommend it to those people, just not me. We all have our own flavors, our own tastes, right? So very different recommendations on these, but I think there is a good audience out there for each of them. Okay, now we're going to jump into a book I just loved, all the way over to the 4-star range for me. Now, I am a huge Louise Penny fan. If you are not familiar with Louise Penny, she is a Canadian author. She writes a mystery series called the Inspector Gamache series. It is set in a fictional town called Three Pines. There is a consistent set of characters that traverse the books that live in Three Pines, as well as some characters that do come and go. It is her writing, I think, is just so poetic and lovely, but also gets very dark. So I would definitely not refer to her as a comfy, like a cozy mystery writer at all. But there is a cozy element to her writing. I get so excited every time I see she's got a new book coming out. So The Man is a Crowds, I don't even know now what number this is. Do you have to read the books in order? You certainly don't. Each one is very much a standalone. But you definitely appreciate the nuances of the characters because you know all their history. You know their personalities. So I would, because I think the series is worth it, definitely recommend the series to anyone that's ever read it. But if you're one of those people where you're like, none of the plot lines intrigue me, but this one does, then go for it. You can definitely pick this one up. This particular book takes us back to the town of Three Pines. Some of the books are set in other countries or areas of Canada. But here we're back to Three Pines. And essentially what I thought was so brilliant is she pulled the COVID climate into this story. But it is post-lockdown phase. So I think it was before when she was writing this, we hadn't fully rolled out vaccinations yet, and a lot of our regulations hadn't lifted. But she is sort of forward thinking, what would that look like? And that's the environment she set the characters in here. Now, there is a speaker coming to, I think it's a college or campus near Three Pines, that is very not conflicted, I forget the word I'm looking for, but controversial. And therefore, they ask Inspector Gamache, our main character, if he would essentially be on site with the team to prevent any uproar with the crowd, and if anything were to occur, and just kind of keep their eye on everything and ensure safety. And that's what he does. But things do unfold, and he himself has strong feelings about the speaker and the message she's bringing to the campus. And it is just so beautifully woven into what Louise Penny does with all of her mysteries. You have the murder, or you have the threat that's in place, but then she layers on psychology and sociology, and we just really get to the underlying human experience and the emotions and the relationships, and we'll get to know a little bit more of the backgrounds to some of the characters. It's just so beautifully done. So Inspector Gamache, basically things come to a head. It's starting with this job, and it leads him down the course of the investigation, which, as always, requires pulling back of numerous layers, where he learns more about some people that he has known for years in the course of the investigation. Just a beautiful story. And it is titled The Madness of Crowds, which essentially was the theme for this whole literary journey. Unfortunately, these two just weren't for me. So, as always, I do have links below to the books if you decide to, you want to pick up any of them. And let me know if you do. I will be so curious. Even when I don't like books, I always love hearing people who like them, what they like. I love all the different viewpoints. I just think that's really cool. So I definitely want to hear if you decide to tackle a book, and then, of course, what you thought of it. Totally fun. That is it for this literary journey review. I've got many more coming, so stay tuned. And as always, thank you for being a part of my literary life. Happy reading.